Dr. Raj Kalsi joining me from Chicago. Good to see you. Thanks for coming on, Doctor.
Thank you, Natalie. Thanks for having me on again.
Sure thing. The world is grappling with this pandemic while we now have protests and support all over the world of George Floyd and Black Lives Matter. There's concern for the protesters massing together, but first I want to get your thoughts on the data. In the U.S., data indicates the number of deaths and hospitalizations from COVID has been steadily moving lower. What's your reaction to that?
I believe it because I see it in my own experience. In the different hospitals I work at, in particular one major institution, we're seeing 50% less COVID patients, not only coming in but being hospitalized. But Natalie, we're getting really good at treating COVID patients. Initially, back in March, these patients would be coming in with very low oxygen levels. And because we didn't know much about it, we would ventilate them. And it turns out that ventilating them early on is a bad thing and actually may have caused some deaths. So it's great that science is moving forward as we predicted months ago, and you and I discussed months ago, and we are learning. So I do see this trend going down as a good thing. And also from an epidemiology standpoint, I think the less aggressive viral strain of COVID is being favored.
Well, that is all good news, and you're right. You know, the frontline workers like yourself have figured out more about how to treat this horrendous virus. We don't even want to think about what happened right when it broke out and the folks that we've lost that tried to do that early on. Well, we mentioned New York City is starting its first phase of reopening today. The numbers down in that city as well. What will be important for people and establishments now to make sure there's not complacency?
It's a great question. And the thing is, this is all just a great big experiment, isn't it, Natalie? I mean, we really are just moving forward in something that's uncharted and nothing we've ever seen really before in this modern time. We can compare this to many other pandemics from before, but the modern time is very unique. So we have to look for people to commit to at least some minimal PPE, like a cloth mask or any type of mask, and some distancing, and also good hygiene, as we've implemented in my own family. We made an agreement that we shower before and after any meeting. And it's things as simple as that and hand hygiene that can really make a huge difference in decreasing what we call morbidity, meaning people who get sick, and mortality, meaning people who die from this virus.
Washing hands, wearing masks, and it's not even that difficult, is it? Also, the protests around the world, you see a lot of people wearing masks, and they're trying to stay safe, and they're outside. So there's hope that perhaps there won't be an uptick in cases as these rallies, these clusters, continue to happen en masse around the world. What do you think?
Well, I think it's fortuitous that these protests, which are very well deserved by those who want to speak their voices, I think it's fortuitous that it's happening in June versus March, because I think if it happened in March, we would have seen exponential deaths and increases in cases. And speaking to the fact that we think we're seeing the less aggressive virus being favored and less people getting COVID, I think that bodes well for these protesters, and we may not even see an uptick in COVID cases. And look at all these people that are protesting in general. They tend to be younger. A lot of them are wearing masks. It is outdoors. There is some contact here and there, but I hope that in general, it's not a huge uptick.
Same here, you know, and we should know in a matter of days as well. It's been almost 2 weeks that people have been on the streets. We always appreciate you coming on, Dr. Raj Kalsi, and we wish you the best because we know you're still working on this. Thank you.
Thank you, Natalie.